In this video, I will talk about short circuit. I will show you different kinds of short circuit, and after that I will show you an example of circuit in which I have to calculate the total current when a short circuit occurs. What is short circuit? Short circuit is the direct connection between two terminals through a very low resistance path. That means I will connect any two points in a circuit through a very low resistance path. Usually we assume that the resistance of that low resistance path is equal to zero. Let's say I have three resistors R1, R2 and R3 connected in series with a voltage source of V. Now let's say I have two terminals. One is at this terminal and another is at this terminal. This is our terminal A and this is our terminal B. Now this A and B terminal will get shorted if I connect these two terminals with a very low resistance path. Let's say this path has a resistance of nearly equal to zero. Then I can say here we have a short circuit. When short circuit occurs, the resistance of the circuit becomes very low. As a result, the greater current will flow in compared to the normal current, and high current flow through that path can cause severe damage to the circuit components. The short circuit may occur due to the insulation failure or components get shorted in the circuit. Now to clarify the concept of short circuit, let's say I have this circuit. Here I have a voltage source of 9 volt and a light bulb of 10 ohm. In the circuit I am getting a current of 0.90 ampere. Now let's say a short circuit occurs in this circuit across this light bulb. Short circuit. See, as this is a copper conductor, therefore it will have a very low resistance. You'll see when short circuit occurs, there is no current flow through this light bulb and the current is equal to 6272.83 ampere, whereas our normal current was only 0.90 ampere. So this is short circuit. When two terminals are connected with a very low resistance path, therefore a high current will flow through that circuit. As a result, a current much greater than the normal current will flow in that circuit. Now let me talk about different kinds of short circuit occurs in a series and parallel circuit. First one is partial short circuit. Partial short circuit, that means a short circuit will occur in a part of a series circuit. To show that, let's say I have a series resistance of 10 ohm, 20 ohm and this 30 ohm. Here you will see this circuit is supplied by a voltage source of 9 volt. As a result, we get a current flow of 0.15 ampere. Now see, when the circuit is in normal condition, I am getting a current flow of 0.15 ampere and we are getting a voltage drop of 1.5 volt across this 10 ohm resistor, a voltage drop of 3 volt across this 20 ohm resistor and a voltage drop of 4.5 volt across this 30 ohm resistor. Now let's say a short circuit occurs across this 20 ohm resistor. As that short circuit will occur only a part of the series circuit, you will see it will increase the total amount of current in this circuit. As a result, previously here we have a voltage drop only 4.5. Here the voltage drop increases due to the increase of current. See voltage drop across this resistor has also increased. Okay, here previously we have voltage drop of 1.5 volt, now it is 2.25 volt. So when a partial short circuit occurs in a circuit, this resistance will get eliminated and the total resistance of the circuit is reduced. As a result, we get high amount of current in the circuit. Due to the high amount of current, I will get increased voltage drop across each resistor. See, in normal condition here we have a voltage drop of only 1.5, here we have 2.25, and in normal condition here we have a voltage drop of 4.5, but under this short circuit condition here we have a voltage drop of 6.75 volt. See, as the current has increased, therefore I will get larger amount of I square R voltage drop across this resistor and also this resistor. That means due to this short circuit we will get higher power dissipation across each of the resistor in this partial short circuit. Now let me talk about this second one, dead short in a series circuit. Dead short in a series circuit, that means all the components in the series circuit will get eliminated by a short circuit. See, our series resistor R1, R2 and R3 are connected across this terminal and this terminal. A dead short circuit will occur if I connect these two terminal across the voltage source with a very low resistance path. Therefore, you will see the series combination of R1, R2 and R3 will be discarded from our circuit. As resistances has been removed, you will see we will get a large amount of current in this circuit. And in this kind of circuit, if we don't use any protective device like fuse or circuit breaker, severe damage can occur due to this kind of short circuit. See, in this circuit, in normal condition, we have a current of 0.15 ampere. See, this is the voltage source and 10 ohm, 20 ohm and this 30 ohm resistances are connected in series. Now, a dead short circuit will occur if I connect the two ends of the series resistor with a very low resistance path like this. See, if I short this circuit, you will see the resistance, there is no electron movement through this series circuit. That means this circuit gets disconnected from our original network and current is flowing now in this direction. See, in normal condition, our current was only 0.15 ampere. Now our current is 8128 ampere, which due to this short circuit, in this circuit I am getting a very large amount of current. And if this kind of fault occurs in any physical device, smoke, fire or explosion can occur in that circuit. Third case is partial short circuit in parallel circuit. See, in this circuit we have R1, R2 and R3 connected in parallel across a voltage source of Vs. Now, partial short circuit will occur if only a certain portion of any parallel branch gets shorted. Let's say this is our resistor R3. Some portion of this R3 gets shorted with this terminal there, and this will be our partial short circuit. Due to this short circuit, the value of R3 will be reduced. As the value of R3 is reduced, you will see due to this short circuit, the total resistance of the circuit will be minimized. As a result, higher current will flow in this circuit. Now let me talk about dead short circuit. Dead short circuit occurs when all the resistances are eliminated from the circuit. As a result, the total resistance of this circuit RT will be nearly equal to zero. As a result, excessive amount of current will flow in this circuit. Due to high current flow, there will be excessive damage in the circuit if we don't use any protective device like circuit breaker or fuse. How the dead short circuit occurs in this parallel circuit? See, let's say this is our A terminal and this is our B terminal. If I connect this A and B terminal with a very low resistance path, the resistance R1, R2 and R3 will get discarded from our circuit. As a result, the circuit resistance will be nearly equal to zero. As a result, very high current will be flowing in the circuit. Now let me show that. See, here we have resistance 10 ohm, 30 ohm and 20 ohm connected in parallel. Here we have voltage source of 9 volt. As a result, we are getting a current of 1.65 ampere. Now, if dead short circuit occurs, that means, let's say, this end of the voltage source and this end of this voltage, let's say this end of this voltage source and this positive end of this voltage source gets short circuited. Therefore, you will see there will be no electron movement through this 10 ohm, 30 ohm and this 20 ohm resistor. As a result, the total resistance in this circuit will be nearly zero, so that a high current, say 6434.69 ampere. In ideal case, the current should be infinity, but due to the wire resistance, a high current 6434.69 ampere flows in the circuit, and this is a very high current. If we don't use any protective device, excessive damage can occur due to this kind of short circuit. Now let me show you an example in which I have to calculate the source current. See, I have to calculate the source current for this circuit. Source current, that means I have to calculate the current that is supplied by this source. Let's say that current is our total current IT. Now to calculate the total current in this circuit, at first I have to know the value of resistance with respect to this terminal and this terminal in which our voltage source is connected. Now let's say this is our A terminal and this is our B terminal. As this is A terminal, as I'm moving along the same wire, this will be our A terminal, this will be our A terminal, and this will be our A terminal. That means this A and B terminal indicates the same path. See, across the A and A terminal we have a resistance of 15 ohm. That means I can cancel this 15 ohm. See, across this A and A terminal we have a series of 10 and 15. That means I can disconnect this 10 and 15 ohm. See, across this A and A terminal, across the same point or a short circuit, we have 10 ohm connected. That means I can disconnect this 10 ohm resistance also. Now look here, you'll see as we have a total short circuit throughout this path. Across this short circuit we have a resistance of 5 ohm which is connected, see, across this A and A terminal. Therefore this 5 ohm resistance will also get discarded. As a result, the resistance RT in this circuit will be equal to 0. Now to calculate total current in a circuit, I have to know the total supply voltage. Here supply voltage is 10 and I have to divide that voltage with total resistance. Here total resistance is 0. That means I will get a very high amount of current, which is infinity in case of the short circuit.